In this video, you'll see how to automate modernization actions with AWS Application Migration Service. With this solution, you can modernize migrated applications and servers on AWS using predefined post-launch modernization actions, and build your own custom modernization actions with AWS Systems Manager, or SSM, documents. We'll begin in the AWS Application Migration Service console. Let's view the post-launch template. This template provides the default set of post-launch modernization actions assigned to every new source server. We'll edit the settings to allow AWS MGN to install the SSM agent on newly launched servers and execute the actions. We'll use the default deployment option so that the deployment is fully tested before moving into production. Let's save the template. Here are all our available post-launch modernization actions. Actions with an active status are configured to be executed from the lowest to highest order number. For this demonstration, let's activate Disaster Recovery to provide resilience for our target environment. Next, we'll select the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, or AWS DRS region, we want to replicate to, and then save the action. Now that this action is included in the post-launch template, it will be applied to new servers that are added after this point. Next, let's look at the post-launch settings for one of our source servers. We can see that our template has automatically populated the actions for this server. Let's create a new action for this server to execute after a launch. Let's name the action. Note that the checkbox labeled "Activate this action" must be selected to ensure the action runs automatically after migration. Next, we'll select the Systems Manager document name we would like to execute upon migrating. We can use public SSM documents or ones we created and uploaded. We'll use the AWS Create Image document, which allows us to automatically create an Amazon Elastic Compute Cloud or Amazon EC2 image by providing an EC2 instance ID. Next, we'll add a description. Systems Manager documents can have multiple versions. For this example, we'll use the default version at runtime. We can specify the order that actions will be executed in. Let's continue with the default order number, which will order this action after all the previously defined actions. The action parameters change depending on the selected SSM document. If a document requires an input parameter that isn't available until an instance is launched, we can use a dynamic value. We'll use the dynamic value and add the action. Now, let's launch a test instance to execute the post-launch modernization actions for this server. We'll return to the source server's migration dashboard to track the lifecycle of the server and monitor the status of its replication and post-launch modernization actions. Let's fast forward to after the actions have completed and the first boot has succeeded, and look at the post-launch actions for this server. We can view the disaster recovery action in the AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery console. We can see the recovery instance of our server and manage the DRS settings from here. Now, let's select the action name to view the action command that executed with SSM. We can view the output to see additional execution details and logging messages regarding the executed action. Next, let's open the EC2 console to review the Amazon Machine Images, or AMIs. We can see the image that was automatically taken with our SSM document. You've just seen how to automate modernization actions with AWS Application Migration Service. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.